Hey brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in the Philippines trying to make a quick video. I felt led by the Lord to look up what is the meaning of jade helm. I haven't heard anybody talking about that I know of. There's a lot going on with Operation Jade Helm in the United States, and I'm hearing all these reports and stuff. I've been seeing like Dave Hodges. We were on a radio show together there with Brother Jason Egroff on the Revelation News before, and he has a website, Common Sense, and I keep seeing articles come up through him and other sites. Anyway, brothers and sisters, the Lord had just led me to go look up what is the meaning of Jade Helm. And because, let me say this, I was in the Army for 10 years, and they always have names like Operation Desert Storm, Operation Desert Fox, Operation Desert Shield, whatever. They have all these names, and they always have a meaning. They always have a specific, significant meaning. And so, out of the blue, the Lord had told me had led me to look up what's the meaning of Jade Helm. Now, here's the bottom line. Jade being green, and it represents a new thing, a new way of doing things, a change of direction, a new beginning kind of a thing. Helm means, like a ship has a helm. It's a small, like the wheel on a boat. It's a small thing, but yet it controls a great big ship. So like a change of leadership or a change of direction, a change of control. And I believe that it means, a change to a new way of doing things, a new world order. What does it say on the back of the money? Announcing the Seclorum Novae, whatever it is. Announcing the new world order on the back of the $1 bill there in Latin. Seculorum. You guys can look on the back of the dollar bill, look it up. Announcing the arrival of the new world order. And I think that's what it's referring to, brothers and sisters. And I just wanted to make this quick and put that out. Praise God. When we see these things are really happening now, we've had all these birth pains, but now it's getting real. You know what I'm saying? In Europe, for the Europeans, it's getting real with the almost collapse of the euro, which will talk about chaos and it could be, some famine and all those things. We knew these things are going to happen. So we see the euro about to collapse. We see the NATO going up against Russia. You're talking nuclear war and all this stuff. All these crises in the Middle East, all those nations are roaring, as Jesus said. Nations are in an uproar and upheaval, wars and rumors of war in the Middle East and all that stuff, and everywhere. And then here in the United, I'm in the Philippines, but in my home country, United States, and the government, their propaganda has changed the name to the homeland, and that's a whole nother topic. This brainwashing to get people to think of America as just part of the new world order. We're all a global community. This is my homeland, but I am a world citizen. See, that's these simple things like pro-choice. I'm pro-choice. Instead of saying, hey, I'm for killing unborn babies in the womb, they say, I'm pro-choice. It's just a matter of brainwashing the low information masses. And for too long, too many Christians have been low information people. Now, I've been following all these things since the 90s, or at least since the 90s, I've been following all these world events. And I just haven't spoken about it because, the Lord has had me focus on the salvation and all these things, biblical things. I want to say this too, and this is a warning from the Lord. The reason why I've been talking about people being baptized in the Holy Spirit and being filled with the Holy Spirit is because, brothers and sisters, the day is coming when, barring the rapture, because the rapture, if those who are raptured, it won't matter anymore, okay? It's just, besides the rapture, put that aside, living in this world, looking at it at the world today, there's only a matter of time before the internet's down, whether it be an EMP, go look these things up if you don't know what I'm talking about, low information, and you don't know these things, EMP bomb over the United States, wiping out the internet, or the man, they put a kill switch on the internet. They already used it like in Iran and other places. They've got a kill switch. They've had one. They put a back door on everything. Go research all these things. These are true. They've got a back door on everything. They've been monitoring every email and every call and all this thing for years and years and years, way, way back. Not just recently, this stuff's been going on. So the question is, this is a whole other topic though. Why is the man, why did Snowden go to Europe? I want to tell you the truth. I guess I need to make another video. Why did Snowden go to Russia? And why is Snowden coming out now? Why is this, he's supposed to be some low-level guy who's a contractor. The next thing you know, he's revealing all these top-level secrets. I'll tell you why. I'll tell you what's going on. This is the truth. in my opinion, this is what I think's going on. I said, let me back it up. This is my opinion, and I feel, you know, led by the Lord on this. In my opinion, there's a power struggle going on at the top level between the military-industrial complex. The, you know, as I made a video, I'm going to put the link. I want you to watch the video I just made, the last video I made, because lots of you guys don't even know these, none of this stuff. But you, and you should get off of the status of Facebook and learn something of what's going on all around you. The world is falling, and we need to know this information to share it with non-believers. People need to get saved. Need to become born again and get right with God, because time's up. What's going on, I believe, is that, you know, that you've got the NSA, the military-industrial complex, who are, you know, the neoconservatives, the neocons, who have a plan to have an Anglo-American world dictatorship, a.k.a. the kingdom of the Antichrist, but they might not know that or understand that it's Satan will rule them, or maybe some of them do at the higher levels. It doesn't matter. There's minions at every level who think they're going to be part of the man's plan. They're on the A-team with the man, and later on the man's going to dispose of them like Hitler did the Brown Church. Go look that up. So anyway, those people, the NSA and the FBI and all those guys, they're at odds with the Fabian socialists, the communists, the socialist people like Obama and Bill Clinton and Tony Blair and all those guys who want to rule the world, but not through America and England, but through a worldwide trilateral thing, the Trilateral Commission and all that. So they're at odds. So what we see is, I believe, coming from the Fabian socialist camp. They are the ones who are trying to make the FBI look bad, the CIA, the NSA. That's why a report just came out yesterday about the FBI covering up that Saudi was, you know, 17 of the 19 hijackers of 9/11 were Saudis. And if you go look, the CIA is the one who came in and overrode the American embassy employee who's been a whistleblower. He refused to give that Atta guy and other people visas. They fired him, and they brought in the CIA, came in and said, it's a reason of national security. We need to give these guys a visa. Those people that did the 9/11 attack. And now it's fashionable. It's finally fashionable to people to say 9/11 was an inside job. When, you know, some people were saying it from the very beginning and even predicted it was going to happen. And then they were shunned. Now, myself, I came to the knowledge and understanding, and I was already a pastor. I didn't really care. I didn't want to get involved like lots of you guys, but we got to be involved. 2003, as a former military veteran, I saw the invasion of Iraq, and I said to myself then, there's no connection between Iraq and 9/11. Most low-information Americans don't know that. Low-information people in the world, these shallow-minded Facebook people, and I'm talking about Facebook status people, and all this nonsense, they don't know that Iraq had nothing to do with 9/11. The Iraqi dictatorship, the Libyan dictatorship, the Egyptian military dictatorship, all those countries were bringing stability, controlling radical Islam from bringing trouble to the United States, bringing stability to the part of the world. This is common sense. But now the Fabian socialists have created all this instability there because they want to follow what it says on the back of the dollar bill, which is from the Kume Sibyl, a quote from a mystical, you know, a woman who's possessed by the spirit of Apollyon. Apollyon, Apollo, same thing in ancient writings. Apollyon is Abaddon, the destroyer, the captain of the beast, the bottomless pit, the spirit who will possess the person who is the Antichrist. Apollyon, the destroyer. Abaddon, Apollo, same thing. And that phrase on the back of the dollar bill is a quote from Apollo, and it says, out of chaos, a new world order. So therefore, brothers and sisters, what we're seeing is chaos. It's that old dialectic problem that the man uses over and over again. The Illuminati, the man, Satan, and his minions have been using for thousands of years. It's called problem, reaction, solution. And what they do is they have a problem. They want to bring in a new world order. People don't want it. So what do? Their idea is they want to have a new world order. So what do? They create a problem. Is ISIS in America beheading people? So they have a solution, martial law, and produces what they wanted from the beginning, which was a new world order. Do you see what I'm saying? That's just one. You've got the collapse of the euro, collapse of the dollar, you know, all these wars, nuclear wars, Ebola. You know, so it's just a bag of tricks of what the devil wants to use to bring in his new world order. The only thing stopping him is God. You know, God's timing of when the tribulation will begin. And so for us Christians, We, the church, our job is to be salt and light. Our job is to inform people of all of these things and how it relates. We have to look at all that stuff, like Alex Jones stuff and all the New World Order stuff. We look at that through the lens of the Bible and tell people, hey, this is what's going to fulfill and bring about the kingdom of the Antichrist. Wake up. Have yourself informed, but don't be afraid and don't get caught up in fear and all that. But you need to be aware, you need to be informed, you need to be alert. And then you need to ask yourself, what are you going to do? If the rapture hasn't happened yet and martial law goes down, and just like what they did to the Jews in the 1930s, are you going to go along peacefully to the FEMA camps? Are you going to escape to the mountains? Or, you know, what are you going to do? And don't listen to the government agents and operatives who are trying to tell you Romans 13. As I mentioned in the video I made yesterday, go back and look at it. Romans 13 says that you're supposed to submit to authorities. Well, in America, for Americans specifically, we are endowed by our Creator with certain inalienable rights. And we, the people, are the government. So we are our own government. We don't have a king or a queen on this earth. Jesus Christ is our king. We're endowed by our God, our Creator, with certain inalienable rights. So that's what's so dangerous to the man, that our authority is God. Now, when the rapture happens, of course, that's going to be the time when all this is, when the restrainer, the power of the Holy Spirit working through the church as salt and light, is removed. Of course, that's when all hell's going to break loose. All bets are off, and America will be never, it was going to be gone, boom, like that in the blink of an eye. America, as we know, will be gone in the blink of an eye. Now, they've been chipping away and chipping away, and that's what I'm trying to tell you. It's because of Christians. Where were you Christians? Where were we Christians when over 50 million babies have been born in the United States? Where are we Christians when they outlaw prayers and all this kind of stuff, and military chaplains can't say in the name of Jesus, but yet they're pushing all this Muslim stuff and having school kids wearing burqas in California and all this stuff, and they took out mom and dad from the kids' school books in California and all these places? Where was the church? Why is the church allowing all this nudity on television? You know, there's porno movies, and then they didn't even really make a stand against that. Now there's even nudity on regular TV. Where's the Christians at? They bleep out, someone says, hey, what's up, fag? Like, if you go see an old movie from the 80s or before or whatever, and someone says, hey, what's up, you queers, you fags? They bleep that out, but they don't bleep out, taking the Lord's name in vain or the F word and stuff like that. But they bleep out some slur against somebody. Politically correct. Where were we Christians when all these things were going on? We got to give an account to the Lord as the body of Christ. That's what I'm talking about. That's the bottom line of all this stuff we're talking about. Where is the church? Look at those European countries. They're 15-20% Muslim now. You know why? A Muslim's got a free shot right over there. Let's not talk about the natural, but the man is doing it on purpose. But there is no power of the church there. There is no power. There are very few. It's like Europe is like 2% Christian, less than anywhere else in the world. I mean, the Philippines, 5% born-again Christian. Europe is 2%. There's no church to occupy and be in power. There's no restraining power of the Holy Spirit through the church to be salt and light. That's what's happened in the United States. The church is disappearing, going away, because people are falling away, or then young people aren't getting saved. And we are becoming no longer a Christian nation. It's not Obama's fault. Obama said that, and we should take it as a warning, because if there was a real strong American church, he couldn't have got away with saying that. But he got away with it. It wasn't even considered a big deal, but just by a few people. So that's what it's telling you. It must be true. Where's the response of the church? I got to go, brothers and sisters. I got lots of things to do. I try to post this video. And I'm working on the words for people and all that stuff. And all these videos I got to make, the Lord is just dropping it on me, brothers and sisters. But I got a word from the Lord, too. Civil war is coming to the church. It says civil war. I don't know if it's, over the... And I believe, in my opinion, it's over the homosexuality. I also believe we have racial, problems in the United States, all created by the man and the lack of the church. All these situations are caused by the devil's people. And also what people don't talk about... You're talking about Obama and all the devil and all this Antichrist and all that stuff. What about the church? Where's the church? Let's talk about ourselves, what we can do. Let's start talking about what the devil's doing and where's the church?